Let's talk about the starting lineup for the Mean Green. We've got guard Decky Johnson. He's always a threat. What do you see with him today?
Decky Johnson is an incredible player. He's averaging 15 a game. But let's not get too involved with the stats. He's a team leader in the past 1.5 seasons that he's been here at transfer from Edgelina College. He's a leader on and off the court, and I think he'll be huge. If he has a huge game, then look for this to be a very competitive game for the Mean Green.
And how about the freshman coming on strong, A.J. Lawson, the guard?
I tell you one thing. Tony Benford, head coach of the UNT Mean Green, can really recruit. This guy is from the same school as Texas A&M transfer J. Michael Reese, and he's proven that, you know, he can compete at the NCAA Division I level, and his game against Texas College past two games has been a very critical part of this team's 3-game win streak.
And what would you say about the experience that's on the floor for the Mean Green right now? Of the five, we've got two seniors and a grad student, coupled with one freshman and one sophomore bringing up the youth. So what do you think that can do for the Mean Green here today?
It's really important to have seniors on your team, of course. Someone who's been there before, Jeremy Combs, a great leader on and off the court, as he has been his whole 3 years here. But it's also important, I mean, as you know, to have the younger players, something to build around for the future. And hopefully the Mean Green can compete in the Conference USA for years to come. And A.J. Lawson looks like a definite great starting piece.
Now, Jeremy Combs, not one of the starters tonight. He's been missing some time with an injury, but it is projected that he could return to the lineup tonight. What kind of impact do you think that could have on today's game?
Jeremy Combs is the best player on this team. And
flat out, huh?
He is. He was definitely missed the past four games. Fortunately, the Mean Green have won three of those games. Ricky Bryce Jr., the sophomore 7-1 guy who is starting tonight, or starting today, I guess. He has really picked up the slack, but Jeremy Combs definitely missed, and he will, if he's active for this game, this could be a very good game, and one of the Mean Green can definitely win.
Jeremy Combs, the junior and the Dallas native, sporting the number one, and as you said, Matt, one of the key components of this team. If they can get him back today, which it is projected that he will be on the floor, that will be a huge boost for this team against a hot UTA Mavericks. I don't know about you, but I'm excited to get this thing rolling. We got a team on a three-game winning streak and a team on a 4-game winning streak. Anything can happen.
Anything can happen. They're rivals. They've played each other over 50 times in their school histories. It should be a great rivalry. We're an hour apart. I would like to see us play them every year.
It's going to be an intense one. I remember my freshman year watching these two teams play. I believe UTA came out victorious in that one. UTA, I believe right now, the Mean Green lead the all-time series from what I understand. However, the Mavericks have gotten the better of the Mean Green in the previous three matchups. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. And the UTA Mavericks have brought their fair share of fans.
Yes, it does. We have got a good turnout for today's game in this drizzly weather on a Saturday afternoon. A good number of UTA fans and a good number of Mean Green fans here on the home side as we head to midcourt for the tip-off. The Mean Green win the tip-off, and this game is underway from the Super Pit. Jermichael Reese will bring it up the court. He will pass it out to number 12 here on the edge, right behind the arc. Another dish out over in the corner, trying to set something up. That is Ricky Bryce Jr. who will take the shot. It is no good, and the Mavericks will bring it back up the court. Setting up around the perimeter. Mavericks dishing around, looking for a way to get into the paint. Jorge Bilboa takes the ball, he will shoot, and he records the first points of the game. That was Jalen Jones with the shot, and now here the Mavericks get the ball back. They pace it up the court, nearly turn it over themselves, almost goes out of bounds. They'll attempt another long three, and that one is good. And so right out the gate, the Mavericks with a quick 6-0 lead.
three-pointers have been something the Mean Green have been susceptible to giving up all year. They average 8 allowed a game.
So Jamichael Reese trying to set something up here for the Mean Green. They want to score quickly and see if they can stop some of this quick Maverick momentum. He'll dish it back to Decky Johnson here in the corner. They'll try and set up a three-pointer, and that one is no good. An offensive rebound now here, and the dunk is no good for Ricky Bryce Jr. The Mavericks will bring it back to the floor. They want to try another three. That one is no good. And so the Mean Green will take the ball back. They're going to try and score some fast break points. Heading straight for the basket here on a layup. That's no good. The Mavericks retain possession, and here we got a stoppage of play. And it is a foul on North Texas. And so the Mavericks will inbound from their own end of the court. Number one, Eric Neal brings the ball into the Mean Green zone. The Mavericks hanging around the perimeter. They have liked that long ball so far. Neal setting up on the far side of the court. He dishes inside the paint to number 25, Kevin Hervey. The conference preseason pick for player of the year scores, and now the Maverick lead is 8-0. A.J. Lawson will try and work his way into the paint. He'll attempt a shot. That's no good. Eric Neal, again, pushing the Mavericks up into the Mean Green zone. They'll try for another three. That one is no good, and a long rebound.
Long shot, long rebound. That's usually how it works.
The Mean Green trying to set up in the corner themselves. Jamichael Reese now drives into the zone. He attempts a shot. That's no good. The Mean Green having some trouble getting those shots to fall here early. Now the Mavericks turn it over. Mean Green again trying to set up in transition. And now they'll slow the pace down. That is Decky Johnson that'll try a long three. That's no good. And finally a bucket falls, but it looks like it's going to be an offensive foul on North Texas. A.J. Lawson gets called for charging.
Already second foul for A.J. Lawson. His presence will be missed, to say the least.
Not a good start for A.J. Lawson. Not a good start for the Mean Green. The Mavericks holding on to an 8-0 run, and A.J. Lawson, the dangerous freshman guard, now heads to the bench with two fouls to his name.
These two teams are playing 100 miles an hour. It's hard to generate good shots when, you know, two passes and throw something up.
A very fast-paced game. I wouldn't say that the Mavericks are getting better shots necessarily, but they are falling. Now they'll turn it over. A pass into the paint pays no dividends. And the Mean Green taking up the court. A pass gets deflected off a Maverick player and out of bounds. The Mean Green will retain possession, it appears. Alante Holston will inbound for the Mean Green, and Jamichael Reese will bring it up the court. Darrell Green passing it out. Reese with the ball again. He'll take another shot from the paint, and finally a bucket drops for the Mean Green, cutting the deficit to 2-8.
Reese probably the best shooter on this Mean Green team. Small sample because he missed a couple games to injury, but in a small sample size, he's averaging 46% from the three-point line.
Yes, Reese the guard, finally getting the Mean Green on the board. Now the Mavericks off another miss. The Mean Green will bring it back up the court. They're looking to get something fast going, but they turn it over. A pass in the paint, picked off by the Mavericks.
And look, he's on the court, Mr. Grant Higby. Jeremy Combs, number one.
Jeremy Combs making his first appearance for the Mean Green since coming back from injury, and he will be a welcome appearance. They'll now try to play defense here. And the Mavericks add to their lead. Now 10-2. Now the Mean Green trying to push it up the court. Setting up a long three-pointer. It's good. The Maverick lead sliced 10-5. First good three-pointer for the Mean Green tonight. The Mavericks, once again, trying to set up around the perimeter. They've been dangerous there so far. They're going to attempt another long three, and that one falls for Eric Neal. And so, once again, the Maverick lead is back at 8 points. All right. So we've got a timeout here. Looks like it was called by North Texas and understandably wanting to slow things down. So far, Matt, the Mavericks kind of having their way around the perimeter. That is, I believe, the 4 3-pointer to fall for them. What are they doing right?
Well, when you play zone, like...
Okay, we're going to take a quick break here, and we will be back in just a second from the Super Pit. You're watching Mean Green Basketball on ntTV.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
Hey, this job looks perfect. It says you need people skills?
Check.
Driver's license?
Check.
And a high school diploma. You've got one of those, right?
Skip the drama. Get your diploma.
I got that.
You are good to go.
Take that first step towards a better future. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
Welcome back to the Super Pit, where the UTA Mavericks have built themselves a comfortable lead here early, 13-5. Matt, the Mavericks are setting up nicely around the perimeter, and they're getting their three-pointers to fall. What are they doing right?
It looks like everything, Grant. When they head down the court, they don't go towards the basket. They go to their position behind the three-point line, and all three of their three-pointers have been pretty open, wide shots. Mean Green, hopefully the defense will adjust.
We'll see if the Mavericks can keep that up or if the Mean Green will make those adjustments here as the Mavericks inbound. They look to be liking that perimeter.
But when you
back out to Eric Neal, he's been running the show so far.
When you play zone defense like the Mean Green have a lot under head coach Tony Benford, you're susceptible to two things, offensive rebounds and three-pointers, like you just saw another one being shot up there, grabbed by Jeremy Combs.
Eric Neal having no fear here early. He's taken his share of three-pointers and passes from the perimeter. That one doesn't fall. The Mean Green take it back up the court. Jamichael Rice, he's been trying to orchestrate the Mean Green attack for the better part here in the first half. Darrell Green fakes a shot. He dishes down to Jeremy Combs, who is back for the Mean Green. A three-point attempt is no good, and the Mavericks rebound. Eric Neal bringing it back up the court, trying to do it all himself. He dishes out. Pass back to Neal, nearly batted away. Neal making moves on his own. And another three falls for the Mustangs, or for the Mavericks, excuse me. The Mean Green, they bring it up the court and shoot one that falls, but only after an offensive traveling is called. So the offensive foul on the Mean Green will give the Mavericks possession of the ball right back. They've got an 11-point lead. Mean Green trying to stop the bleeding here early. The three-point shots have been raining for the Mavericks so far. Let's see if the Mean Green try to adjust perimeter defense. Here's a turnover. Nearly stolen by Jeremy. Excuse me, no, that's Jamichael Brown. Nearly stolen, couldn't quite get control of it. It's out of bounds off his foot, and so the Mavericks will retain possession. Here's Eric Neal going into the paint, dishing back out for a three-point attempt that comes up short. And now Jamichael Brown at the other end on a quick score will cut the deficit to 16-7.
Good play by Brown to get ahead of the defense and for that easy fast break opportunity.
And so the Mean Green trim the deficit back down to single digits. Here's Eric Neal operating. He's had the ball in his hands a lot here in the early going. Eric Neal trying to create separation. dishing out. The Mavericks will drive into the paint. The layup's no good. An offensive rebound, and now a tip-in is good. That'll extend the Maverick lead, and it is back out to 11 points. Mean Green looking to come right back. Decky Johnson now taking the ball. He's going to go into the paint himself. He'll put up a shot. No good. Mavericks rebound. Eric Neal once again with the ball in his hands. Setting up around the rim. He dishes in. That ball is picked off.
Mean Green have had some active hands early on here to try to counter the Mavericks' quick start.
And now they'll slow things down as they bring it into the Mavericks' side of the court. Alante Holston takes the ball. He'll pass out to Combs. Back to Holston. He'll put up a shot that's no good. Mavericks rebound. And they like putting that ball in Eric Neal's hands. He'll bring it up the court, dishing out to, I believe that's Harris. He's going to take it in himself. And the layup is no good. Can't get the favorable roll. The Mean Green will take the ball right back up. Jermichael Brown, he's seen some action here since getting on the court. Mean Green heave up a shot. That's no good. And Eric Neal once again will bring the ball into the Mean Green side of the court. The Mavericks looking to pour it on here in the early going. The Mean Green trying to get something going to turn it around. They've played decent defense at times, forcing some turnovers. Can't seem to get much going at the offensive line. But here's something might go. A turnover, but a stoppage of play. Let's see what's going on here.
Jeremy Combs is going to be begging Tony Binford in the huddle to make him point guard.
He's been doing quite a bit with the ball in his hands. And in the, you know, the Mean Green love having him back.
I believe that's his second steal of the game already.
So the Mean Green able to create some things on the defensive zone, having trouble getting some shots to fall on offense.
That's when I think when your jump shots aren't falling, you need to really get the ball inside, get some easy layups, easy closer shots, and when those easier shots start falling, it'll give you more confidence from outside, start shooting those mid-range three-point jumpers.
The Mavericks have established that shooting the three ball is their game, but it does not appear to be the game for the Mean Green right now. They need to be driving into the paint and taking some more quality, higher percentage shots.
Right.
So now we see the officials having a discussion over at the booth while both coaches gather their teams in for a pep talk. And we'll see what is being discussed. They're apparently looking at something. Okay. We're going to be taking a quick break right before returning back to Mean Green Basketball here at the Super Pit. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
Things you've done with your bike, donating it to Goodwill may be the most incredible of all. Your donations help fund job placement and training for people in your community, which means your stuff can be more powerful than you think. Goodwill. Donate stuff, create jobs.
Welcome back to the Super Pit, where it appears the teams are getting ready to go again. There is still some discussion amongst the officials. Not sure what they're looking at. They may be looking at to see if Jeremy Combs was contacted when he was pulling away from the Maverick defense with the ball. We're going to see what implication that has on the game. If they rule that a clear path foul, Combs would shoot free throws and the Mean Green would retain possession.
The Mavs had no interest in being part of his highlight reel, obviously, did not want to see that poster dunk in his first game back since that four-game stretch of not playing.
It looks like they may have indeed ruled that that was a clear path foul. Combs is headed to the free throw line to shoot a pair of technical free throws. And these will be some welcome points if Combs can get these to fall. He misses the first one.
Not a good free throw shooter. If he could just improve his free throws, his free throw shooting, he could be a very dangerous player.
I think he is a very dangerous player.
He is a very dangerous player, but
that's another element he'd like to add for sure. The Mean Green, desperate to get some offense going. They are one for their last five shot.
But you never want to be a victim of those hack-a-whoever positions where, you know, you can foul and easy two misses.
Absolutely. Combs was headed to the basket for a highlight reel slam dunk. It looked like the Mavericks opted to stop that. However, since it was a clear path foul, the Mean Green will retain possession in addition to the two free throw attempts. The one good made free throw by Combs cuts the deficit to 18-8. The Mean Green now back on the attack.
And it's obviously a smart decision to foul in that situation, but I really would have liked to see Jeremy Combs finish that play, get this Mean Green fan base up and loud, because up until now, all you've been hearing is Mavs fans.
All right, and another shot that comes nowhere close. That didn't touch rim, so it won't reset the shot clock. Combs tries to put one up. That's no good. The Mavericks rebound, and they immediately dish into the paint. They try and go up, and he is fouled almost immediately. That was Jorge Bilbao that had two guys trying to take him to the ground as he went up to the basket, so he will shoot a pair of free throws. The Mavericks here trying to generate some offense of their own. They've gotten the three-point shot to fall, but the possessions have been sloppy. They've turned the ball over three times in the past 2 minutes. In spite of that, though, they have now stretched their lead to 20-8. So number 52, Jamichael Reese, has come back into the game. He will take the Mean Green up the court, trying to once again get the offense going. Defense has looked decent, more or less. The Mean Green still trying to get points. This is
nice.
Very good. A slice into the paint by Decky Johnson, and the Mean Green have double-digit points for the afternoon. Now here come the Mavericks. Back up the court, they shoot a ball that it rims out, and the Mean Green trying to push the issue. Jamichael Reese quickly up the court. He puts up a shot that rims out as well, so the Mavericks back the other way. They've taken Eric Neal out of the game, it appears. They've loved him running the court, but they dish to the corner and put up another three-pointer, their fifth one of the afternoon, and that's going to push the lead to 23-10.
When you get that much time and space to shoot, I think even you, Grant, could have made that shot.
You may be giving me too much credit, but we will see. And so now the Mean Green back up the court. Jamichael Reese and Decky Johnson on the outside trying to set up the offense. Decky Johnson's going to put up a three-pointer. That just misses and rims out. The Mavericks will take possession back up the court. And now the Mavericks will turn it back over. The Mean Green back up the court trying to get something going. They are only two for their last 10. Trying to generate a quality shot opportunity.
Just trying to do too much with, you know, only 3 seconds. It's a 40-minute game. Mean Green have plenty of time. Of course, we all would like to see them get started, but you can't just throw yourself into the pack like that and, you know.
Trying to get a little too cute with the ball that time, setting something up. They end up turning it over. And so now, once again, the Mavericks will head up the court. Setting up around the perimeter again. They have loved that arc so far, and why not with 5 three-pointers made already? Now they'll crash inside. Number 25, Kevin Hervey, the All-Star, he'll put up a shot. That goes in. And now the Maverick lead is the biggest it's been tonight. 25-10, a 15-point UTA lead. And so now Jamichael Reese will come back up the court. He'll heave it inside. The Mean Green will put up a shot. That rims out.
Ricky Bryce coming off that great game he had against Texas College, 15 points, career high, and a double-double, second of his career. think he's really improved his jump shot, his free throw shooting as well this year.
Well, the Mean Green fans are hoping. He's headed to the line for two. The first one takes a favorable bounce and falls in. Now the second shot to cut the UTA lead to 13. That one is swooshed.
I'm going to take partial credit for those two-for-two free throws.
Maybe Ricky Bryce Jr. would let you. So now the Mavericks back up the court. They're going to put the ball in the hands of their all-star Kevin Hervey. And now trying to generate offense around the outside with Jalen Jones. And passing the ball a lot. They are not afraid to share it. Here's Jalen Jones on the outside. Back to Kevin Hervey, who puts up a shot. That's no good. The Mean Green defense grabs the rebound. They'll head back up the court. And now a quick shot attempt. That falls. A three-point shot by Jamichael Brown. And that may have been the spark that the Mean Green were looking for.
That's how you like every fast break opportunity to go. A lot of space, a lot of time for Jamichael Brown, who swished that through.
Here, right at the other end, Jalen Jones of the Mavericks getting a lot of space, but he whiffs on that three-point attempt. The Mean Green again trying to put the pedal to the metal on their fast break transition. They're coming up the court, now trying to set up offense. Deke Jones passing back out to Darrell Green. Back around. Back to Jamichael Reese. And another three-point shot by Jamichael Brown. He's feeling lucky. That's no good. The Mean Green get the offensive rebound.
One thing I will say about this Mean Green team is that nobody on this team is afraid to go up and get a rebound, whether on the offensive or the defensive side.
Sure does not seem like it. It looked like Deke Johnson went up and had the ball swatted away. The Mean Green will retain possession. And as we have a timeout here on the floor, we will take a break and be back in just a few moments. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
Hey, it's Ava, and this is Tess from Bebo's Do It Yourselfie, where we recreate the hottest looks from today's biggest music videos.
After cleaning out our closet, we have a lot of clothes we don't wear anymore.
Like this old t-shirt.
It's not garbage, it's actually a brand new rug.
And to make it, all you need to do is cut, tie, and glue.
Cut the t-shirt into strips.
Tie the strips into knots.
And glue the knots to the bath mat. I love it. Give your garbage another life.
And recycle.
We taught him how to hit a baseball. How to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. But how much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
And we're back from the Super Pit, where the Mavericks are still leading comfortably. The Mean Green, though, trying to generate some offense. They'll have possession of the ball when we get back to action. The Mean Green right now desperately trying to generate some points. They are shooting an abysmal 21% on the offensive side of the floor. Matt, what do they need to do differently? Because the shots are falling for UTA, and they are not for North Texas.
Well, you keep seeing jump shots for the Mean Green. Not every time, you know, I would think you would shoot, if you shoot four straight jump shots and you miss them, you might want to go inside and get some easier shots and get some more confidence, because 21%, that's not a pretty number.
We're going to see what they can generate right here. Yes, definitely. See what they generate here as they inbound. They're going to send it back out to Deke Johnson. He'll go over to Darrell Green, who now passes it back out to Jamichael Reese. Back to Jamichael Brown. He's been hot lately. They're going to try a long shot here. That rims off. And good effort, but the Mavericks come up with the rebound. They have got Eric Neal back in the game, who has been running the show for the most part for UTA. He dishes over to Kevin Hervey, who now heads to the corner. Back to Eric Neal. Mavericks trying to set something up. The Mean Green have everything shut down inside. They'll send it over to Kevin Hervey, who puts up a three, and that is golden. Swooshed from way downtown. And UTA now shooting 50% from beyond the arc.
It's fun to watch how the three-point shot has evolved, not just in college, but professional, high school. And you almost need to have good three-point shooters now to be a good team, because it's such a dangerous weapon.
I would say so, at the professional level and the college level. So that was Ricky Bryce Jr., who went up and emphatically slammed down a dunk, but it's not going to count because there was a stoppage in play beforehand. The Mean Green will retain possession. Jamichael Brown takes the inbound pass, looking to set something up from beyond the arc. He dishes it back over to Alante Holston.
Don't you wish you were 7'1" sometimes?
It'd make dunking a lot easier. Now here goes Decky Johnson into the paint. His shot looked like he was contacted, but it completely misses the rim. And it appears, after going out of bounds, it will remain North Texas ball. On the inbound pass, Darrell Green takes the inbound. Over to Alante Holston, back to Decky Johnson. He goes into the paint, drives, and was fouled. Let's see if that was in the act of shooting or not. And the Mean Green are now on a bit of an alarming scoring drought. They do not have a single point in 2 minutes. And the Mean Green will dish back in. Jamichael Brown takes possession of the ball. He'll charge in, trying to create something. Dish back out. And so now Darrell Green driving into the paint, trying to put up a shot. That's no good. And bit of an amusing chain of events here. A few stoppages in play, and the Mavericks can't seem to get the ball out of their zone. Another Mavericks team foul, and this one, it looks like, is going to result in free throws for North Texas.
One more, and they'll be in the 1-1 situation.
The Mean Green would like to get that bonus, anything to help getting points at this point, as Darrell Green's first free throw is pure.
Mean Green, their first game of the season against Solros State, they struggled from the free throw line, but the past six games they've shot at least 70% or better. And you have Mr. Decky Johnson on the court right here, who is over 85% from the line. So keep getting those fouls. It's not pretty basketball for the fans, but anything to, you know, like you said, generate some points and make this competitive game again.
And so Darrell Green knocks down both of his free throws. The Mean Green needed that, snapping a scoring drought of over 2 minutes. And so the Mavericks putting the ball back in the hands of Eric Neal. They've trusted him with the majority of their offense so far. Now this is Jorge Bilbao. It drives inside and a foul is called. A Mean Green player ends up on the ground. It appears he is not going to get the benefit of the doubt from the officials, though, as Bilbao is headed to the free throw line to try and capitalize on a foul in the act of shooting. These two free throws would put UTA at the 30-point mark, nearly double the Mean Green score.
A lot of stoppages in play, haven't there been?
There's been a few here in the early going. A bit of a sloppy game so far, but the Mavericks.
And Tony Binford tried to get a timeout out of it, telling his players to come here real quick, but referee was having none of that, told him to get back over there.
So Benford's going to have to wait just a little longer. As UTA will look to make it a 30-point lead, the first free throw is golden. Splashed right through the net, pushing the UTA lead out to 12.
Well, we're lucky the Mean Green are a second-half team. They've actually outscored their opponents in the second half this year, so maybe we'll be in line for a good game, I still think.
Well, they're going to need it if they do intend to make this a close one, because the Mavericks have now eclipsed the 30-point mark and now lead the game comfortably by 13 points.
Oh, but never say comfortably when the Mean Green are playing.
Jeremy comes, he dishes inside, beautiful pass. It does not fall, but it appears there was a foul in the act of shooting. And Ricky Bryce Jr. is going to head toward the free throw line.
That's the way. Keep getting the ball inside. Keep throwing up shots. They don't go in. Hopefully you're fouled.
I was about to say, Matt, looks like they're taking your advice. It's not pretty basketball, but the fouls will get them on the board. So it looks like that is what they have opted to start doing as Bryce's first free throw is good. Second free throw up and away for Bryce Jr. That one rims out. And so it will remain a 12-point Maverick advantage. They dish inside quickly. They want to set up and push the tempo. Still trying to get set up around the edge. Neal back in.
That's going to be offensive interference. Bowles.
But like you said, that looks like it is going to be touching in the cylinder. So offensive interference. And no goal for UTA. So the Mean Green with a chance to build some momentum here if they can get points on back-to-back possessions. Brown dishing out to Elante Holston. Back to Brown. Down to Bryce Jr. Back to Deke Johnson, who heaves up a three. No good. Off the back of the rim.
Need to get the ball to Bryce Jr. more. He has 4 inches on Bilbao.
That's a mismatch right there that the Mean Green have yet to take advantage of. Meanwhile, the Mavericks putting the ball back in the hands of old reliable Eric Neal. Dishing around over to Hawkins, back to Neal. And now some exchanges here as they look to set something up on the inside. And now here is another foul that looks like it is going to put UTA in free throw shooting position. And now we have an official timeout here on the court.
Two fouls, nothing to worry about, but.
Hey, what was that? Okay. So the Mean Green, they need to generate some offense here. So let's talk about one of their primary scorers, Deke Johnson, the senior. So what have we seen him do today? The Mean Green early on were taking some ill-advised long shots, you and I felt like. He's been putting in a better effort to try and get them more involved, some more creative passing, and get them in the paint.
Well, he's gone inside like I wish the Mean Green would do more of. He's gotten a couple baskets. The Mavericks have kept him, but they've kept the whole team pretty quiet so far. And he just, as we just saw, he just picked up a second foul and two fouls. You're not too worried, but still 40 minutes left in this first half. You would not like him to see him pick up a third before this. Before this half ended. You don't want to see your leading scorer in foul trouble, obviously.
Agreed. Two fouls, not a deal breaker here at this point. If he picks up a third, a little something to worry about.
I know one of the assistant coaches is telling Benford he has two fouls.
Benford trying to rally the troops over there on the corner. Deke Johnson, these Mean Green desperately needing offense here. Right now, only 2 points for Johnson. He can't say it's for lack of effort. He has attempted 8 field goals, but only made one of them. He's got 4 rebounds, and he is 0 for 4 from beyond the arc.
When it's not working, you know, coaches will normally, or you'll hear the phrase, when your shot's not going, keep shooting, they'll eventually fall. But, I mean, I kind of iffy on that statement. I mean, You want to help your team win, and if you're not shooting, even if you are the best shooter on the team, they will eventually go down. But you need to get the ball inside more, and they've kind of weathered the storm a bit after falling behind 8-0 to start the game. But now it's kind of back and forth. You can't really get too many.
UTA now shooting free throws, the first of which is good.
Eventually, we're going to get to a point where you can no longer trade baskets. You're going to have to either play more man defense or, you know, get some better shots, find a way to get some better shots.
Agreed, and that deficit for the Mean Green now 14 points as both of Wilson's free throws are pure. The Mean Green, their only points in the last 4 minutes and 10 seconds have come off of free throws. They have gone that long without a single made basket from the field. And you can only think part of that has got to do with Deke Johnson. They need to get their primary scorer involved as Jamichael Reese takes the ball from beyond the arc. They'll dish it back out to Jamichael Brown. They've been calling his number a lot here in the early going. And now Reese with a three ball that is good.
Best three-point shooter on this team. Small sample size, like I mentioned earlier, but he's great addition from this team, from transfer, of course, from Texas A&M.
And boy, did the Mean Green need that, as that will put them over 20 for this first half. The Mavericks right back, though. A good pass inside, but well defended. And so now a turnover. The Mean Green defense comes through to generate an extra possession. And so Alante Holston will push the ball up the court. He'll dish to Combs inside. They'd like to see him going. He will dish back out to Jamichael Brown. Brown's going to go inside, try to make a move. He'll try and put up a layup that's no good.
I think it was
Kevin Hervey comes away with the ball.
I think he thought what he had one of his offensive guys there, but when he saw that nobody was there, he had to throw it up.
Meanwhile, another turnover, a pass inside, ends up getting picked off by Alante Holston, which turns into a Mean Green opportunity at the other end. Jeremy Combs off the offensive possession, puts it back up, and the Mean Green are now on a scoring streak, five in a row for North Texas.
Under double digits, a good milestone to hit before halftime. Hopefully they can slice more into that lead.
So the Mean Green have found some momentum here in the closing minutes of the first half. They need to keep that up if they want to make this a game here in the second. The Mavericks will take another shot from downtown. That one's no good. The Mean Green offense can push it back up the floor. Let's see if they want to go here early. Jamichael Brown entertained the idea of a three-pointer. He'll instead go inside, dish it back out to Jamichael Reese. His shot's no good. The Mavericks will take the ball and push it back up the court. And now UTA on a bit of a scoring drought themselves. They have not hit a field goal in the last 4 minutes. They're trying to change that here. A dish back out to Eric Neal. Dish around back to Wilson, and that one's no good. And now a loose ball foul, which is going to give Mean Green the possession.
Mean Green were scrambling so much on that play, it made me tired.
Can't credit them for lack of hustle. And there was a loose ball foul on the Mavericks, and I'm not so sure if that doesn't put the Mean Green in the bonus. It appears it does, as Jeremy Combs is heading to the free throw line.
I believe that is their eighth team foul, so they will have 1-1 until 10, which...
So all of a sudden, this deficit, which was 14 points, could be half that if Combs can knock down these free throws. The first is good. And so now we see a substitution being made here in the final minutes. The freshman guard, A.J. Lawson, coming back into the lineup. He left the game earlier with two fouls. Combs about to attempt the second free throw.
Always like
that one is good.
Going into the second half.
And so what a change of pace here. What was a 14-point deficit has now been cut to half of that with seven straight points by North Texas. And now the Mavericks frantically trying to get the ball moved around as the Mean Green are pressuring every pass.
It's about some three-fourth.
And now
zone.
Another turnover. The ball out of bounds off of Wilson of UTA, and the Mean Green are going to take possession. The Mean Green looking to keep the hot streak going.
Whatever Benford said in the huddle must have inspired them. And that's going to be a
foul. Nearly committing a turnover themselves, but
it
results in a foul, and that's going to result in more free throws as the Mean Green are in the bonus.
A little too eager there on the defensive side.
Agreed. The Mavericks right. The Mavericks right now can't knock them for not being aggressive, but they've got to play smart basketball. Just not a good foul to take there with the Mean Green having momentum and in the bonus, especially when they were struggling to shoot field goals early on. The first is good, and that is going to cut the deficit down to six.
You know, a free throw contest is never going to get good ratings on TV, but if you can make free throws, you're going to win a lot of games. And Mean Green so far have shown that they can make their free throws, take advantage of those opportunities.
Oh, you may have just jinxed A.J. Lawson as he misses the second. And now UTA going up, fouled on the shot. They are on a bit of a field goal drought themselves. It has been 5 minutes, more than 5 minutes, since they knocked down a shot from the court. So the Mean Green, once down by 14 earlier in the half, have trimmed it to sixth. The Mustangs will look to increase it again, and they do with this first shot, which falls. And the second UTA shot is good as well. So the Mavericks get a little more breathing room, pushing the lead back out to 8.
2-for-1 opportunity for the Mean Green. Hopefully they see the clock and they know the situation.
1:08 left. They've got a chance to, as you said, use that time to their advantage. And we'll now set up behind the arc with Jamichael Reese looking to generate a good offensive possession. They'll dish to Combs down underneath the basket. He puts up a shot that's no good. He gets the rebound, and the shot rolls in.
Mavericks won offensive interference on that play, but
it looked questionable for sure. They ran away, signaling to the officials, but they're not going to get the call. The deficit is back down to 6.
And it looks like if they get a rebound here, or, of course, if the Mavs make a shot, they'll get the last possession of the first half, and they'll have that successful 2-for-1. That's going to be an offensive foul.
And now a call here. Offensive foul.
Now they've got 25 seconds to work with. Set up an offense.
What a turn of events here at the half. It looked like the Mavericks were on the edge of running away with this game. Now a surge by the Mean Green, and they could go in to the half with as small as a 4 or 3 point deficit.
They were hitting everything they were throwing up earlier in the game, but, you know, we're all humans, as you might agree with me on that. Everyone's going to go through slumps. There's going to be basketball's game of runs, and we're seeing one here by the Mean Green.
The Mean Green defense, a big part of that. It has been some time.
Benford will use that timeout to set up his last play of the first half.
Okay, so we're coming into the closing seconds of the first half. We obviously saw UTA jump out to a pretty sizable lead, but it was you, Matt. It was you that said you can't get comfortable. It was you that said you can't get comfortable with the talent that the Mean Green have on the court. And so far, they are making you look pretty smart. They've trimmed the deficit down to 6 points, looking to slice into it even more with the last 20 seconds here in the half.
And right now, if I'm Benford, I'm. You haven't had many jump shots fall for the Mean Green. They've gotten back in this game with free throws and, you know, shots right under the basket by Combs and Price. So I'm. You have 20 seconds here. 20 seconds time. 20 seconds is plenty of time to get an offense together, get a good shot, and it'll be a three-pointer.
They're going to try and set something up. They got a three-pointer out of the corner. It's not going to fall.
Good,
but they're
going to
get the offensive rebound. Combs, another one. The Mean Green continue
great
to retain possession.
Green,
although Combs needs some help over there in the corner.
Darrell Green just threw himself out of bounds to save that ball, and landed perfectly in the Mean Green player's hands.
And so a flurry there in the North Texas offensive zone. And the Mean Green, after all of that, are going to retain possession.
5 seconds still in an eternity in almost every sport.
And so the Mean Green have really worked their way back into this game with hustle, because the shots are still not falling for them. In fact, as you can see here, UTA still out shooting them percentage-wise by a pretty hefty margin. But they managed to redeem themselves with bonus offensive possessions, with good defensive play. They've generated quite a few turnovers. What do you see them doing here on the stat sheet that seems to generate? Well, excuse me. We're about to inbound here for the last shot. They're going to dish out to Jamichael Reese. He loses the ball, though.
I believe that's going to be a late foul call. They will get 2 shots with 2 seconds left.
Wow. And so the Mavericks wanting to make sure the Mean Green didn't get an easy bucket, but another foul is going to put them at the free throw line.
And going off what you were just saying, when teams get behind by 10 or 15 points, their defense, you really start playing desperate on the defensive side. You saw a lot of steals by the Mean Green in that comeback run. And when you're still not shooting as well, like the Mean Green still aren't doing that much, like you said, 24%. You have to get those easy shots by the basket, like I said earlier. Get to the free throw line, which the Mean Green have taken advantage of so far in the first half. 2 more free throws for the Mean Green.
And so with the two free throws, the deficit is now cut to 4. They're going to get it out to Neal at half court. He's going to heave up a shot. That had a chance, but it rims harmlessly off the backboard.
I don't know about your bank, Grant, but my bank closes at 12 on Saturdays. So,
so no bank shot there for Neal, and the Mavericks will have to settle for a 4-point lead, which was at one time a 14-point lead, but a surge by the Mean Green has trimmed that deficit down significantly. So real quick before we go to commercial, let's talk about some of what we saw there in the first half, because you see here on the stat sheet, 24% shots falling for the Mean Green. That is horrific, as opposed to 40% for UTA. When you see that big of a disparity, you expect it to be a pretty one-sided game, which it was for a while, but the Mean Green have come back and they have made it a contest.
Well, like I said earlier, when you are playing bad on one side of the floor, you start playing desperate on the other side, of course, defense. So those steals, the Mean Green had, I guess we will expand on that once the second half
begins. When we come back, yes. We will come back with some more analysis when we get back from commercial break. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
Hey, this job looks perfect. It says you need people skills?
Check.
Driver's license?
Check.
And a high school diploma. You've got one of those, right?
Skip the drama. Get your diploma.
I got that.
You are good to go.
Take that first step towards a better future. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
The inherent right to work is one of the elemental privileges of a free people. Endowed, as our nation is, with abundant physical resources, and inspired as it should be to make those resources and opportunities available for the enjoyment of all, we approach re-employment with the real hope of finding a better answer than we have now.
Donate to Goodwill, where your donations help fund job placement and training for people in your community. You've done with your bike, donating it to Goodwill may be the most incredible of all. Your donations help fund job placement and training for people in your community, which means your stuff can be more powerful than you think. Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs.
Hey, it's Ava, and this is Tess from Vivo's Do It Yourselfie, where we recreate the hottest looks from today's biggest music videos.
After cleaning out our closet, we have a lot of clothes we don't wear anymore.
Like this old t-shirt.
It's not garbage. It's actually a brand new rug.
And to make it, all you need to do is cut, tie, and glue.
Cut the t-shirt into strips.
Tie the strips into knots.
And glue the knots to the bath mat. I love it. Give your garbage another life.
And recycle.
We taught him how to hit a baseball. How to hit a receiver. The strike zone. The net. You taught him how to hit the upper corner. You even taught him how to hit the open man. But how much time have you spent teaching him what not to hit?
Looks like it's done.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Hey,
Hey, did you know 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Let's go to theshelterpetproject.org and meet a few who are in a shelter near you. Harlow. Oh, she's one great listener who loves to hear all your stories. My kind of cat. Cerulo is a sweet, goofy boy who's eager to please. Sounds just like another dog I know. So go to theshelterpetproject.org, search your local shelters and rescues, and go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.
Thanks for coming in for the interview.
Oh, yeah, of course.
All right, we got your personal references, your resume, high school diploma or equivalent.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma.
Yes, it's right there.
Great.
Take that first step towards a better future. Find free adult education classes at finishyourdiploma.org.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
Everywhere that we go, he makes people laugh and makes people smile, and I feel like I have that quality.
He's the one who always takes me fishing.
I watch golf with him. And
I watch him cook, because when I grow up, I want to be a cook too.
We have the same faces like this.
Dad is the one, when you fall, that picks you up.
That unconditional sense of presence and reassurance is really what makes him my father.
Love is love. Love is love.
Don't let E. coli mosh with your food. An estimated 3,000 Americans die from a foodborne illness each year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So always separate raw meat from vegetables. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise. And be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
New dad is picturing a treehouse in the sky, but he's ignoring the instructions.
Good luck, big guy.
His kids know that he's building without a clue. Never been so good with nails and glue. Now we're trapped inside a box. I hope mom knows what to do.
Mom!
See, you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
I will not be news today. I will not make another push to be the first man in space with frosted tips and a puka shell necklace. And I will not go viral when my terror is caught on camera when I finally realize that in the vacuum of space, no one can hear you sing. I'm Lance Bass, and I will not be trending today because there is a much bigger story that needs to be heard.
I will not be news today. I will not make headlines by going through a bad girl phase where I get that bad girl haircut where they shave just one side of your head. And I will not bring a Komodo dragon as my plus one to an award show, even though that would be awesome. I'm Olivia Munn, and I will not be trending today because there's a much bigger story that needs to be heard.
De saber en dónde puede encontrar a su familia en una emergencia. Inicie su plan.
Na, 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 na. I love you so. I love you. I love you. La 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 la. La 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 la.
We're here.
Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
This new mom is struggling to get the skates just right. And now she's holding on for dear life. Her kids can see she may have broke her knees. They still love her, though she looks like she's attacked by killer bees.
I'm allergic.
Proof you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I
One in five children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
Hi, may I please have an application? Thank you.
Skip the drama. Get your diploma.
Welcome back to the Super Pit, where we are getting ready for the second half. Both teams are out warming up. Okay, Matt, let's talk about that first half a little bit, because we got some interesting numbers here. As we said, the Mavericks took a 14-point lead. It now sits at just 4. What did the Mean Green do to get themselves back into this game?
Mean Green, their hands became more active. They got so many steals. If you look at the numbers, Mavericks are shooting 40% compared to 24% of Mean Green. It's only a 4-point game, but Mavericks have 10 fewer shots because of all the turnovers the Mean Green enforced. And turnovers, defensive turnovers, free throws like the Mean Green were finally able to convert, that will help you get back in games.
Very good point. A possession is only worth anything if you're getting a shot off. And the Mean Green have been shutting those shots down after the Mavericks were able to get some early three-pointers to fall.
I believe it's 6. I lost count.
It was quite a few. There was a flurry there. The Mavericks are now just one for their last nine attempts from the field.
Yeah, and now let's look at the impact players. Jeremy Combs, as we know, this is his first game back from a four-game absence due to injury. He didn't start, but he came in, you know, very quickly, and he's doing work down underneath, 7 points and five rebounds.
The Mean Green are ecstatic to have him back. Now let's talk about a guy that's causing them some problems on the other side, and that is Kevin Hervey of UTA. And we had a feeling he was probably going to be an impact player here today.
You know, when you're recognized as preseason pick for player of the year in your conference, it's usually not a fluke. And we all know what happened last year. Was averaging a double-double before an injury before the game that made him miss the rest of the year. Now his scoring isn't there as much as it was last year, but he's, as you see, 10 points, 5 rebounds in this game. You see that he's just as capable as putting up the same numbers as last year.
It certainly seems so. So both of our impact players with recent injury histories, and now they are having huge impacts on the game for our team as we get the second half underway. The aforementioned Hervey inbounding in to Eric Neal as the Mavericks try to set up the first offensive possession.
Starters back in, though. Bryce underneath, and another three-pointer for the Mavs, huh?
There they go. They would like to get back to that. That was how they built their initial lead, was with effective shooting from beyond the arc. After getting away from that was when the Mean Green began to go on a run. The Mean Green now try and set up their own offensive possession as Jermichael Reese takes the ball out, back in. He'll dish out to Decky Johnson, who's going to put up a shot at the arc. And that ball rims out, takes a favorable roll. The Mean Green can't control it. They get the offensive rebound. They'll try another shot that also doesn't go in.
Mean Green have had a lot of offensive rebounds like that, and we're throwing up three or four shots possession. That'll also affect your field goal percentage.
Eric Neal furthering the idea that the Mavericks would like to get back to that arc shooting. He heaves one up. That's no good. The Mean Green take it back, but then turn it over underneath the basket. UTA will push it back up the court. They want to get a quick shot off, and they do. A transition point dish to Kevin Hervey underneath the basket, and he lays it in for an easy two.
Another quick start, two halves in a row.
Let's see if the Mean Green can slow it down once again and get on another run of their own. They're operating outside the arc. Decky Johnson, he'll dish back over to A.J. Lawson. Back down to Bryce Jr. underneath the basket. He'll pass it out. It goes nowhere except out of bounds, and so that's going to result in a change of possession favoring the Mavericks.
Bryce thought Decky Johnson was going to stay in the corner there, but Johnson was cutting and results in another Mean Green turnover. Second to begin the second half.
A slight miscommunication there. The Mean Green don't want any of that. Turnovers were how they got themselves back into the game on their defensive end of the board. And so now Eric Neal, he's found the ball in his hands a lot here this afternoon. Trying to set up outside. And A.J. Lawson draws another foul here, his first here of the second half. And so now Jeremy Combs is back into the game, as is Jermichael Brown. Those guys have had their numbers called quite a bit here this afternoon. So the Mavericks back to work. They operate with Neal, winning the point. Out to Hervey, back to Neal. Over to Jalen Jones in the corner. He drives and gets fouled.
Mean Green foul, number one, Jeremy Combs, his first, second Mean Green team foul.
Foul was not in the act of shooting, so the Mavericks will retain possession. No free throws, and now we got another whistle here.
Offensive
and
foul.
This one's an offensive foul before the pass is even inbounded. So a break in the early Maverick aggression here as Jermichael Reese will take the inbound pass. He'll dish it out to Decky Johnson. He's had a rough night so far. He would like to get his numbers going. And now here is Reese tries to drive inside, loses possession, and gets fouled.
Second Mavericks team foul.
And so the Mean Green will inbound back in.
Another offensive foul back-to-back on the unbounds, inbounds plays.
And that's a shame because they were setting up for a nice three-pointer there in the corner. So some sloppiness on the offensive ends for both units here as they come out to begin the second half. Neal finds himself double-teamed. He dishes his way out of trouble. They'll try to pass it inside to Hervey. That doesn't work, but we're there to clean it up. Is George Bilboa.
And almost he a great lays defensive play for the Mean Green there.
Very nearly, but Bilboa is there to clean it up, and he's able to lay it in. Now the Mean Green will dish to Combs underneath the basket, and he lays it up for an easy two to get the Mean Green on the board for the first time in the second half. The Mavericks are trying to bring out their star power. They're getting Hervey. Hervey. And Eric Neal involved here early. The three-pointer is no good, and now that appears to be a loose ball foul here on the UTA Mavericks. And so Darrell Green will check out of the game. Amonte Holston back in his place. Now the Mean Green trying to set up on offense. He'll dish over to Jamichael Brown. Back out to Decky Johnson, back to Brown. Brown operating on his own, back to Reese. Reese making some moves, he'll dish inside, and that ball gets batted away by the UTA players. It's kept in bounds, or the Mean Green will scoop it up and score.
A little occurrence of look what I found, and it results in an easy two for the Mean Green.
That was eloquently put as Reese scoops up a loose ball and is able to put it into the basket. Now UTA trying to score here quickly. They missed the shot, nearly rebounded, and it appears that a loose ball went out of bounds off of a Mean Green player, so the Mavericks will retain possession. Dish it to Neal. Out to Jalen Jones. Going down to Bilboa. Underneath in the paint. That shot's no good. The Mean Green will bring down the defensive rebound, and they're going to push it right back up the floor. Here comes Reese. Sending it down to Decky Johnson in the corner, and it looks like he was fouled on his way to the basket. And with that, we have got a timeout on the floor, and both coaches will rally their troops.
We saw the first 7 points of the half, again, being scored by UTA, but it looks like UNT's weathering the storm, this storm, a little bit more better.
All righty. So after a slew by the Mavericks, the Mean Green looking to slice into the lead once again. We'll see if they can continue when we come back. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
This new dad is picturing a treehouse in the sky, but he's ignoring the instructions. Good luck, big guy. His kids know that he's building without a clue. Never been so good with nails and glue. Now we're trapped inside a box. I hope Mom knows what to do.
Mom! Mom!
See, you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
Na 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 na, I love you so. I love you, I love you. La 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 la, la 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 la.
We're here.
Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
This new.
Welcome back to the Super Pit, where we have just gotten the second half underway. We are just over 4 minutes into the second half, and there was a media timeout here in the early going. We've just come off. UTA committed a foul during a Mean Green possession, and both teams will take the floor again.
UTA got up by 14, 15 points in the first half, and then you saw the Mean Green storm back for and cut it to four, and then you saw 7 straight points by the Mavericks. You don't want to put yourself in another hole, especially this late in the game now.
Here was a long inbounds pass trying to set something up, and it doesn't work as Jamichael Brown tries to run into the paint but ends up turning it over. It ends up in the hands of Kevin Hervey for UTA, and they quickly push it down the court and extend their lead back out to 9 points. The Mean Green would not like to see it expand back to double digits after all the work they did to shrink it in the first half. Here's Decky Johnson faking a shot from beyond the arc. He runs inside, puts up a shot that doesn't hit the rim, and the Mavericks come up with the ball. And dish inside to Hervey, that's just too easy.
That could have been not pretty, but that ended up pretty.
Yeah, Kevin Hervey with the easy lay-in off the transition pass.
Neal was caught midair. He didn't know what he was going to do with it, but he found Hervey again.
So the Mean Green now finding themselves looking at another double-digit deficit as Reese tries to operate from beyond the arc. He'll dish outside. They'll try and get a three-pointer to sink. It misses wide right. And so now Hervey will push the Mavericks back up the floor. They're trying to operate from beyond the arc. They set up inside. The Bass back to Hervey. He tries to go up and lay it in and will succeed. So Hervey with 6 points here just in the second half to give him 16 points on the night. And understandably, the Mean Green taking a timeout to try and slow things down. So, Matt, we saw as that first half came to a close, the Mean Green go on a run to try and stop the bleeding a little bit, but now the Mavericks have opened it back up. What's going on?
Well, in the first half, even when the Mean Green did come back, they weren't hitting jump shots. You saw the field goal percentage. You can ignore the numbers. They weren't making their jump shots. They're not making their jump shots right now. And they're regressing back to how they started the game, shooting a bunch of long shots that have not gone in. In fact, one of their two baskets was kind of an instance of luck where Lonte Holston said, oh, hey, here's the ball, pass, easy bucket. Mm-hmm.
So they seem to have gotten away a little bit from driving to the basket, which was what got them the free throws and the easy lay-ins in the first half. And then defensively, they don't seem to be attacking as well. The Mavericks have been able to get into the paint and get a few easy points off the hands of Kevin Hervey, which was not working for them in the first half. They were getting the long three-pointers, but the Mean Green had effectively shut the paint down fairly well. So far, it's opened back up again here to begin this second period.
Well, the Mean Green had all the momentum going to the locker room, but I always find it interesting to see who comes out hot in the second half, who did a better job adjusting in the locker room. And as you can see so far, UTA is obviously the answer there. Mean Green coming out sluggish on offense, and Kevin Hervey showing you why he's sluggish on defense, on both sides, I guess. And Kevin Hervey showing you why he's one of the best players in his conference.
He was named, as we have said numerous times tonight, a possible pick for the Player of the Year in Conference USA, or for his conference, excuse me. And so far, he has lived up to that hype here in this one, as the Mean Green will now inbound it over to Reese. And they will try and get some of this momentum back as they send the ball over to Derrell Green. That's not the way to do it. Green turns it over. Mean Green able to get back in time to stop an easy fast break point, but the Mavericks now set up. Dish out to Wilson. He'll drive inside. And now a traveling call on Wilson is going to result in a turnover, and the Mean Green will regain possession.
When you turn it over after a timeout, you can just see the head coach shaking his head every time that happens, especially when you're the Mean Green right now. Only one timeout for this last 14 minutes of the game.
And now here, Reese nearly turning it over. He'll send it back to Combs, who sends it back over to Brown. He'll try and drive in, and he gets the basket, and that's going to be an and one.
That's what the Mean Green need to do is drive the ball. And I don't like to say, you know, try to get fouls to maybe show your acting skills and get a few fouls just so you can get some points. Even if they're free throws, the free throws might slow the game down, but you're getting points, you're keeping yourself in the game. You don't want this lead to build up as big as it was, 14, 15 points early in the game.
As we saw in the first half, it isn't always pretty, but it's real good, as Brown's and one free throw attempt is golden to complete the three-point possession. Now the Mavericks will take it back up the court. Their lead cut to 10 points. operate, sending it down to Wilson. He loses the ball, but appeared to be fouled in the process. Foul is on J. Michael Reese, his first. Reese now trying to operate at the offensive end, and now here is a beautiful play drawn up, inbounded, and immediately tipped back in, and that's going to result in an and one for the Mavericks.
Very nice.
Wow, what an inbound pass.
Very athletic, very long reach, and now he's going to get his own rebound on the free throw.
No. And so the Mean Green spared the and one, but then they don't regroup and collect the rebound. And as a result, the Mavericks tacking on another easy 2 points.
You see this too much in the Mean Green all season when they're trailing. We still have plenty of time. Anything can happen in 13 and a half minutes. That's an eternity. But when they get down by this much, they'll start playing fast, and it'll cause bad turnovers like we just saw.
Well, some confusion over there. Jeremy Combs ended up on the ground in the corner out of bounds. The Mean Green pleading their case that there was a foul, but the officials having none of it. Possession awarded to the Mavericks. So now UTA on a bit of a scoring run. The Mavericks have reeled off four straight field goals. They'll operate with Eric Neal bringing the ball up the court. He'll dish out from around the arc, sending it back to Neal. And now Mavericks losing possession. It rolls out of bounds. It is ruled that Decky Johnson reached in and poked it away, so the Mavericks will retain possession.
Obvious frustration there by Decky Johnson. Probably not because of the foul, but just because he's been quiet all game. The Mavericks have been doing a great job keeping him quiet. They're leading scorer for the Mean Green.
You knew he had to be a point of emphasis for UTA's game plan coming in, the leading scorer for North Texas, and so far they've done a great job of keeping him quiet. They'll dish it over to their leading scorer, Hervey, in the corner. He'll send it back to Neal. The Mavericks clearly now trying, they want to get something in the paint. Send it back to Neal, who operates over the corner. He turns it over. Jeremy comes away with the ball. The Mean Green have a 2-on-1. They'll send it back to Combs. He'll go up and put it in. Easy layup.
Pretty play by Combs there. His hands have been active all day long.
And now UTA trying for a quick three-pointer at the other end. That's no good. The Mean Green will take it right back up the court, operating with A.J. Lawson, the freshman. They'll send it back over to Decky Johnson. He'll dish down to Combs. Combs wants a shot from that spot. Good attempt. It bounces off the rim.
We've seen Jeremy Combs' jump shot getting better since his freshman year. He's made that shot a lot this season in the small time that he's played.
Not that time, though. So the Mavericks will take possession, back up the court, trying to set up. They're getting some good drives. No favorable shots, though. Hervey trying to operate. He'll send it back out beyond the arc. They'll take a shot. That's no good. The offensive rebound is out of bounds off the Mean Green. Bryce Jackson unable to haul it in, and so the Mavericks will retain possession. And now we've got a media timeout here on the floor. Both teams will head to their respective benches. All right, and so as both coaches rally their troops, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we will proceed with the second half. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
This new dad is picturing a treehouse in the sky, but he's ignoring the instructions.
Good luck, big guy.
His kids know that he's building without a clue. Never been so good with nails and glue. Now we're trapped inside a box. I hope Mom knows what to do.
Mom!
See, you don't have to be perfect to be the perfect parent.
Thousands of siblings in foster care will take you just as you are.
ballerina.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
Everywhere that we go, he makes people laugh and makes people smile, and I feel like I have that quality.
He's the one who always takes me fishing.
I watch golf with him. And
I watch him cook, because when I grow up, I want to be a cook too.
We have the same faces like this.
Dad is the one, when you fall, that picks you up.
That unconditional sense of presence and reassurance is really what makes.
Welcome back to the Super Pit, where we are jumping right back into action. The Mavericks continuing their possession. They head over to Eric Neal. They like operating with the ball in his hands. They're dishing around the arc, trying to get something underneath. They get it down to Jorge Bilbao.
That's going to put him in the bonus.
That is another Mean Green foul. And so less than halfway into this second half, with 11:47 remaining to be exact, the Mean Green are already in the penalty, and the Mavericks will shoot free throws.
Something the Mean Green took advantage of late in the first half, and now the Mavericks are using that to build their lead again.
The first shot for Jorge Bilbao is good.
Foul trouble, obviously one of the factors in UTA rebuilding this lead. Mean Green aren't playing with their hands as much. They're getting foul calls and not generating as many turnovers. They're getting a little lazy on the defensive side.
Meanwhile,
and that lead is 14 again.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Bilbao knocks down his second free throw, and so that lead is back to 14, which equals their largest of the game. Combs will dish in to Reese. And the Mean Green, still plenty of time left, but you got to figure they got to get something going here, and that's not the way to do it. The Mean Green get called for charging.
So another shot right there.
Yeah, he certainly paid for it with that one. But well worth it. Well worth it, as it is going to earn the Mavericks another possession and another turnover for the Mean Green.
Well, I mentioned foul trouble late in the first half for Decky Johnson, your leading scorer. Now that's his fourth and crucial time in this ball game.
A fourth foul for Johnson, so he is in trouble. He has not had a good night all night long here, as Kevin Hervey just continues the onslaught, knocking down another one from beyond three-point range. And so the Mavericks now have their new biggest lead of the game at 17 points.
Mean Green really need to get away from that zone defense. They need to play more man. I don't know if their conditioning's not well enough or they're just not disciplined enough, but it's resulting in a lot of open shots, a lot of open threes.
As we see there in transition, a turnover by Jeremy Combs results in an easy bucket for UTA at the other end. That lead is now extended to 19, and a timeout by the Mean Green as they are going to try and figure out what's going on, because they are getting rained on.
And that's their last time out the entire game.
Well, Benford apparently thought that it was necessary to use it here, because if he doesn't, well, it may not matter as the game closes out, because it may not be very close.
That's right. If the Mean Green can't get anything started these next few minutes, you might see some of the second stringers getting some PT.
The Mean Green this half have been outscored 24-9. An ugly, ugly, ugly performance coming out the gate for North Texas.
And it just like the first half started, the Mavericks got off to a quick start, and now Mavericks haven't cooled off yet. We're halfway through the second half, and it's still 23-9, like you mentioned. Like I said, the zone defense leaves you susceptible to offensive rebounds and three-pointers, which UNT has given up 8 three-pointers a game, and I believe, what, 8 or 9 today?
this. It's been a lot. And now the Mavericks also getting their star power involved on their offensive side. They've got Kevin Hervey, who now has 19 points on his day. And UTA, they are finally getting their shots to fall. They've outshot the Mean Green percentage-wise all game, but now they are really starting to rein them in. They've made 7 of their last 9, and they're on a 7-0 run.
And they're unlike the Mean Green right now, they're taking care of the ball.
The Mean Green now committing some sloppy turnovers. They try and get back into the offensive zone, and they get many, many offensive rebounds, 4 offensive rebounds, but nothing can go in. And now, finally, it looks like there is a foul on UTA in the act of shooting.
I think that rim's doing its best Hakeem Olajuwon impression.
Like there's a lid on the basket. Mean Green heaved up a barrage of shots, all of them rolled out, and the end result is going to be the freshman A.J. Lawson going to the line to shoot free throws, and that lid may still be there as he misses his first one. Everything, it seems, is working against the Mean Green this half. Turnovers, poor defense, and finally, they get some more points on the board as Lawson's second free throw falls. And the Mavericks, wasting no time, they want to push the pace. They get right back into the Mean Green zone, and now here a ball knocked out of bounds. Looks like by J. Michael Reese. So the Mavericks now back in the inbound. They will operate with Eric Neal. Kevin Hervey over there trying to set a pick. Eric Neal back. He'll dish underneath. Down to Jorge Bilbao, who initially appeared to be stopped, but it appeared that there was a foul as he went up for the basket. Of course, it doesn't matter if it's in the act of shooting or not because UTA is already in the bonus.
That's another easy shot opportunity created by the zone defense not being effective today.
I agree. They need to change their strategy here, and they need to do it quickly because what they've got right now is not working. And so Darrell Green is going to check out. Shane Tamara is going to check back in for North Texas. As Bill Bayo's second free throw falls. The Mean Green will inbound it, and now UTA is bringing on the full court pressure. Now that does open up some opportunities down at the other end. Lawson trying to heave up an early shot. It looks like there was an offensive foul, though, and so possession is going to go right back the other way.
Main purpose of full court pressing defense is to force mistakes by the other team, make them work more quickly. And you saw that the Mean Green taking the bait again, if you will, and another Mean Green turnover.
That foul was on Lawson, and that's going to check him out of the game for now. And so Eric Neal pushing the ball back up the court for UTA. He's going to dish it back over to Jalen Jones, and that three-pointer is going to fall.
Doesn't matter which goal they're shooting at.
And so the slaughter continues as UTA pushes their lead out to 23 points. The Mean Green will try a three-pointer of their own. That one's no good. Jeremy Combs coming in to try and rebound. He manages to temporarily stay in bounds, trying to dance around with the ball, and it ends up hitting the line. And so the Mavericks will take possession once again.
Jeremy Combs gets the nod for me for player of the game. He, in a 23-point game, he's still giving it his all, like you saw there, going up for the offensive rebound. He's got the rebounds, he's got the point production, and honestly, they should start feeding him the ball more down low.
Well, he redeems himself here, forcing a mistake by Eric Neal. The ball rolls out of bounds off of his leg, and so the Mean Green will get possession right back. Here comes Reese up the floor.
And not to mention his active hands, 3 steals tonight, too.
Combs doing everything he can to try and keep his team in the game. But if they're going to have a chance, they need to generate offense, and they need to do it soon. As there's a stoppage of play with Reese. And that's going to be the 6th Maverick team foul. So The Mean Green now just one foul away from the bonus. And Combs tonight, talking about him doing as much as he can to try and keep his team in. He's got 11 points. He's 4-for-7 shooting and has got 6 rebounds.
Say 4-of-7 shooting, he's only gotten 7 shots. They need to feed him the ball more, like I just said.
They would like to get him the ball underneath, but they're not doing it here as another Mean Green mistake results in another Maverick possession. They're going to bring it up the court. They'll dish over to Kevin Hervey. They'll send that back to Jalen Jones over in the arc. Back to Hervey. Hervey trying to create space. Over to Wilson. Back to Hervey. Back down to Bill Baio. And now here's a turnover. Can they keep it in bounds? Yes, they can. They'll go up, try to put the easy layup in. He can't do it, but Combs follows up, pushing his total to 13 points tonight. The Mean Green score an easy transition bucket.
I think Combs knows we're talking about him.
He can try and balloon his numbers if nothing else is. The Mavericks dish down to Hervey. He's going to try and create his own space. And appears to pay off as it looks like he was fouled going into the paint. Well, those aren't quite the numbers Combs wanted to balloon as he picks up his third foul of the game.
It's true. When Decky Johnson has 4 fouls and now Jeremy Combs has 3, not a good factor in your comeback trail.
You need to have your good players out there on the floor, and that's not the way to do it as Hervey continues to add to his large point total. His first free throw drops.
Picking up from last year when he had having a monster season last year. He's picking up right where he left off.
Well, his second free throw falls, and that, I believe, is going to put him at 21 points for the night as the Mean Green try to inbound, and the Mavericks will bring back the full court pressure. Reese will push the ball up the floor. He's going to try and threaten to go inside. They'll dish the ball underneath the Combs. He goes up and under. And so it looks like they have started to take your philosophy, Matt.
Maybe I should have said it earlier.
He's scoring a lot with the ball in his hand, so they're trying to get it to him. He is, you know, this Mean Green team is very happy to have him back, and now UTA will operate. And Wilson slices in from the outer edge to get the lay-in.
Mavericks are getting everything they want right now. Mean Green need to step it up on defense.
Agreed. The Mean Green finally getting some offense, but now the Mavericks seemingly scoring at will.
Mean Green foul.
And this isn't going to help. Jalen Jones pushes the ball up the court. Another foul on the Mean Green. And since they are in the bonus, that's going to result in free throws as we go to another break. All right, we will see you back here with the remainder of the second half when we return. You're watching Mean Green Basketball here on ntTV.
La 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 la, I love you so. I love you, I love you. La 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 la, la 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 la.
We're here.
Yay!
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Welcome back to the Super Pit here in Denton, Texas, where we have got about 7.5 minutes remaining in the second half, and the Mean Green find themselves in a pretty sizable hole. Matt, what's going on?
Well, the Mavericks came out of the locker room. They have made every adjustment their head coach Scott Cross has wanted them to make. Meanwhile, the Mean Green UTA, they came into the game. UTA is the better team. But at the Super Pit, like I mentioned earlier, if we're playing at the Super Pit, the Mean Green have a chance to win every game that that they play in here. But it's just a matter of the players executing. Players are executing for the Mavericks. Meanwhile, for the Mean Green, they've regressed back to how they started the game, with a lot of missed jump shots, getting lazy on defense. And again, like I've said time in and time out, the zone defense is not working for the Mean Green.
And Jalen Jones here, this will help them out, misses both of his free throws as Jeremy Combs rebounds. So a spark of life for the Mean Green if they can get some offense going. Reese takes it up the floor. Operating, they'll send it down. Badly missed shot, but right
there.
That
happened.
Yes, right there to tip it back in was Darrell Green.
Jeremy Combs.
Jeremy Combs is being credited with the basket in that mess of hands that all went up around the rim. So now the Mavericks trying to get a little too aggressive going to the rim. They commit a charge, and so now an offensive foul results in another Mean Green possession. The Mean Green aren't out of it yet, but they are going to need quite a surge here if they're going to make any noise here at the end of this game.
And Jeremy Combs knows this game's not over.
He's still out there giving it everything he's got. They're going to go for the long inbound.
It looked like he had 1 foot over the half-court line.
As long as he doesn't completely cross, I believe he's okay, and that seems to be the consensus that the officials went with. As Reese brings the ball back in, they're going to dish back down to Combs, and he's going to score with an and one. Did not take them long to pick up on your philosophy, Matt.
I don't think he's missed a shot since I said that. Is it? Can we get the guys on that?
I don't believe he has. If he has, I haven't noticed it. And so UNT now has three baskets made by Combs in their last nine possessions. And the free throw for the and one is good. And so Combs providing seemingly the lone spark of life for the Mean Green as we wind down here in the second half. They managed to get the deficit to less than 20. Now what can they do on the defensive end as Eric Neal, the preferred ball handler for UTA, brings the ball up the court. He's going to take it right into the paint, into a mess of white jerseys. Now he'll bring it back out and dish over to Jalen Jones, who he wants to drive. A ferocious block by Jeremy Combs here on the defensive end, and the Mean Green are going to get the ball right back. Combs doing everything he can to keep his team in the game. Now he takes the ball.
It's the Jeremy Combs show.
It is the Combs show. Now he'll try and set a screen. They'll dish it back under to Bryce Jr., but now a block by UTA. And that is going to be a futile possession as the Mavericks bring the ball back up the court.
You've got to make that shot when you're down by 18 here and when you're 7-1, when you tower over every defender that was in your area.
But Bryce Jr., for whatever reason, unable to shake off the UTA defender, and now the Mavericks have the ball back. Eric Neal, so dangerous, distributing the ball. Dishes a three out to Jalen Jones that's no good. It bounces off the rim and out of bounds before the Mavericks can gather it, so the Mean Green will take back possession. So Decky Johnson now will inbound for the Mean Green. The Mavericks intent on keeping that full court pressure up as they inbound to Jamichael Brown. They'll send it back over to Reese, who will advance the ball up the court. Guarding on him is Hervey. He's looking to set up a good offensive attack here. Jamichael Brown going for a three, and he hits.
Much needed, much needed.
A swooshed three from Jamichael Brown to cut the deficit back down to 15. Still not good, but looks a lot better considering what it was.
They've trimmed 8 points off that 23-point lead we had just a few minutes ago. Like I said, Jeremy Combs has put this team on his back in every facet of the game. He's got 19 points. He's rebounding the ball. He's getting to the offensive boards. And he's stealing the ball like he's a point guard. I think he secretly wants to be a point guard, Grant.
He is doing it all. He has put this team on his back here as this second half winds down. And he's telling them, guys, we're not going down without a fight.
They aren't. 15, you have 5 minutes left. crazier things have happened. 5 minutes is a very long time in basketball.
In college basketball especially. So now we will see what the Mean Green are capable of doing. Can they make this interesting? Right now they are on an 8-0 run. Trimming the lead, or excuse me, the deficit from 23 down to just 15.
After we thought Kevin Hervey was taking over this game, Jeremy Combs says, gives him a little reminder of whose house this is.
The two impact players that we talked about coming back in from halftime have not disappointed. Jeremy Combs nearly stealing that one from Bilbao. And now the Mean Green get lucky. What looked like was going to be an easy lay-in rims out.
Ball, I believe, will go to the Mean Green. Possession arrow favors the Mean Green. And it does.
Wow. It looks like they're going to rule a jump ball.
Not exactly sure how that one didn't go in.
I have no idea how that didn't go in. Every law of gravity I'm familiar with dictates that that ball should have ended up in the net.
I'm not even that good at physics, but I thought that ball would have gone in.
But for whatever reason, it rims out, and the Mean Green escape with their 8-0 run intact, looking to extend on it. And now we've got another stoppage of play here. And there was a defensive foul on UTA.
Line him up for the Mean Green.
That may put the Mean Green in the bonus. It appears it does. And so Shane Tamara, who is yet to get on the board tonight, he knocks in his first free throw. And the Mean Green just continuing to try and chip away at this Maverick lead. And his second free throw is no good. It just rims out.
Those rims aren't being that friendly today, Grant.
They are not for either team. So the Mavericks now will dish it back up the court. You wonder now if UTA is thinking about playing the clock a little bit. Some of their lead's been chipped away, and they don't want to give too much time for the Mean Green to do any more damage, they seem to have gained some momentum.
That's right. You see the active hands there by Brown, I believe. Mean Green finally starting to get come alive again, like we saw late in the first half.
It looks like they're finally getting some things to go their way. And UTA was on a 3-minute scoring drought, but no longer, as they put that one in for the easy layup, and now the lead extends back out to 16. But here trying to trim into it is Reese. That three-pointer doesn't fall, and Eric Neal is going to advance the ball back up the court. The Mavericks have numbers.
Perfect.
And here they go.
Perfect fast break.
Dagger to silence the Mean Green momentum as another three-pointer falls to the Mavericks. They've been raining all night.
It's been raining. It has been raining all night. Inside and outside.
Inside and outside. There is no escaping the rain. But now here, Reese, not ready to go quietly. He dives into the paint and lays up an easy two. Your lead is back down to 17 for UTA. There's 3.5 minutes remaining in the second half, 3:25 to be exact. And the Mean Green doing all they can to try and make this game interesting.
Jeremy Combs came out of the game a little bit ago when he picked up his third foul, but I think that break only lasted 1 minute. Tony Benford realizing, you know, however many fouls he has, he's been a huge part of this Mean Green game. It's the only reason they're still in it, with 3.5 to go.
That seems to be good reasoning. No matter what the risk, if Combs isn't out there, they don't seem to have any life at all.
Right.
We were wondering before the game if his return from injury was going to make an impact, and boy, does it seem it has. The Mean Green, I'm not so sure, aren't losing this game by 30 points, if not for Jeremy Combs.
Exactly, and you already have Deke Johnson, your leading scorer, who's picked up the slack while Combs has been out the past 4 games. He's on the bench with 4 fouls, so Tony Benford, he can't afford to have Jeremy Combs out there, too. He can pick up his 4th foul or whatever he wants, but...
And Deke Johnson having a very underwhelming night, especially by his standards. And so Combs right now seemingly the only Mean Green player that is giving them a chance to make some noise here at the end of this game.
I think there are a few bright spots overall is that the Mean Green are playing very shorthanded. They have a couple of transfers, as we have not talked about all day. They have a couple of transfers that will be eligible to play once the semester ends. in the SMU guard in Keith Frazier and Ryan Woolridge from San Diego. They are both eligible to play on December 17th against Sam Houston State. So the Mean Green have some enforcements ready to come back and help them compete in Conference USA.
As we see the graphic there on the screen, Jeremy Combs tonight with 20 points. He's 8 of 11 from the court. And the Mean Green, though abysmal overall, Jeremy Combs has got an excellent percentage right now. It's no wonder they're trying to call his number.
Players will say that the stats don't matter, but truly they do care. Jeremy Combs with that double-double.
I promise you the individual players care.
Oh, yes.
Jalen Jones now, his first free throw good. Going for a second, that is no good. But disastrously for the Mean Green, Kevin Hervey is right there to pick up the rebound. So the Mavericks are going to get an extra possession.
That's the second time tonight the Mavericks have gotten the second possession on a free throw miss.
Looks like the Mean Green are sleepwalking, thinking they can get away with it. But now here the Mavericks commit a turnover, and they're going to dish it right out to Combs, who travels up the court. Can't quite get the layup to go in, but it appears he was fouled driving to the basket.
And hobbling a little bit on that knee.
That is not something that the Mean Green want to see. As you can see, Combs with the knee brace there around his left leg. And they do not want that to get re-irritated in a game that's probably already decided.
Well, we see Decky Johnson back in the game for the first time after picking up his fourth foul, getting that steal and throwing it up to Jeremy Combs. We've seen the past 2.5 years, Jeremy Combs, we've seen that breakaway dunk so many times.
So Benford has opted to bring out all the star power here for a final push. Combs, his first free throw is no good. He just couldn't get the favorable roll on a bounce. He will now attempt his second free throw. Second free throw also takes an awkward bounce, but this one goes in. And now the UTA Mavericks going a little lax with their lineup, it looks like. They've pulled some of their stars. Kevin Hervey, though, still out there just to keep things in check. Wilson operating around the rim. He'll dish back to Hervey. Hervey's sending it back out. They'll send it back down to Bill Bayo, and he's got some trouble handling the ball. The Mavericks will have to force up a late shot from downtown. That's no good, but they do grab the offensive rebound, and that's devastating for the Mean Green as more time continues to burn off the clock.
That physically hurts when you have a 35-second possession, play defense for 35 consecutive seconds, and then you cannot get the defensive rebound.
Get the rebound. That is just demoralizing as a team. UNT continuing a bad night of shooting. You can see almost the entire story just in the shooting percentage as they are shooting 30% from the field to UTA's 50%.
Meanwhile, Combs grabs another rebound, adds to that double-double.
The Mean Green, though, trying to show some pride here. Combs will try and extend the numbers on his night. He can't do it there.
That jump shot has not been working for the Mean Green all night.
Appeared to be an easy shot from that range, but it can't find the net. It rims out. The Mavericks will go back underneath. A good pass and a dish underneath results in an easy layup at the other end. And that is probably going to kill any last thoughts that the Mean Green had of making a comeback. As you can now see, the lead is out to 19 with under a minute and a half to play. So now, Jorge Bilbao picking up his fifth foul, and that's going to put the Mean Green at the free throw line as they're already in the bonus.
But it's a 40-minute game. Ideally, you'd like to play all 40 minutes. I mean, but they're kids. They're 19-year-old kids playing out there. And, you know, you're not going to play perfect the entire game, but it really hurts when you can't come out to a you can't start well like the Mean Green did both halves.
I would agree with that entirely. These kids, they feel demoralized, especially because at the end of that first half, it looked like they really had a chance to make some noise in this game, but UTA came out and has flat-out dominated this second half.
Exactly. They started – the game was 8-0 to start. It was a 15-point lead in the first half that got sliced to 4 by halftime by the Mean Green, who finished nicely. But then the lead got ballooned to 23 because turnovers, not playing well on the defensive end. And hopefully Mean Green can prevent it from being a 20-point game.
Meanwhile, they pick up a split at the free throw line as the second free throw is good. So a minute 23 left in the half. And we'll see if UTA will opt to merely burn time off the clock. At this point, the Mean Green look like they're content to go quietly, so we'll see if that's the approach that they decide to take.
DJ Draper getting the steal.
How about this? And so they will not go quietly. Draper gets the steal, and the Mean Green are back in business on the offensive side of the court.
Side note, Draper leads the Mean Green with a perfect 1,000 three-point percentage, 2 for 2. That's a 2, though.
That one, a long 2, but no good. And the Mean Green have put some of their backups into the game now and getting those starters some rest. The game easily decided by this point. Both teams, it looks like, going deep into their benches, giving their starters some relaxing time. The Mavericks driving to the paint. That layup's no good. The Mean Green will push the ball back up the court. They still want to score quickly. Apparently still some pride to be won here. As number 12, A.J. Lawson, goes up. He's shot no good, but tipped in by number 14, Bryce Jackson.
And by that quick bucket, the Mean Green will mathematically should have another possession, which they will.
As the Mavericks score another quick bucket, and the Mean Green can hold on for the last possession of the game. Can they break 60 points? Is the only thing left to be seen here. They'll give the ball back to Bryce Jackson, and he swooshes in a bucket to get the Mean Green point total up to 61 on the night. And UTA will hold for the final shot. They'll put it up. It's no good. And so that final score is going to stand 77 to 61. Okay, Matt, so not the result the Mean Green were hoping for, but what do they take away from this game?
They take away, it looked like Jeremy Combs was 100% out there. He played with heart out there. He was giving his all, even when the score said, you know, that this game should be over. Double-double, over with 20 points and nearly 15 rebounds there. I mean, UTA is a very tough opponent. They're playing everywhere this season. If you didn't know, 13 non-conference games, 9 of those are on the road. So they know how to win on the road. They beat Texas this year. They beat Ohio State and Memphis last year on the road. So this is a very tough opponent. Mean Green had a lot of positives. Jeremy Combs, for one, he's back. Their question was, can he stay healthy? How will that injury affect him? Well, we saw now that they'll play Delaware State next, I believe, and Jeremy Combs, I imagine he'll be in the starting lineup. He'll give him a great chance to win like he always does when he's out there.
I think so. If tonight was a test run to see how competent Jeremy Combs could be coming back from that injury, I think he passed with flying colors. All righty. So, once again, your final from the Super Pit is UTA 77, North Texas 61. Good night here from Denton, Texas.